I'm going to actually be showing you two approaches to the process. One I like to call the, I'm just taking us back to the home page on this for the toolbar. But one I'd like to call the simple version, and then the other is a little more advanced, so it has a little more tools that are associated with it. Both will get the job done. It's really a preference sort of thing. But I want you to know that those are both options, so you can kind of explore and see which one you prefer. We'll also talk about what trimming the audio looks like, so editing the audio, and then, of course, saving the PowerPoint, which is going to be real easy, probably the easiest thing out of the whole process. So with that all said, let's go ahead and get started. So to kick things off, we want to go to the toolbar that says record. So the tab on the toolbar that says record. If for some reason this is not available on your version of PowerPoint or what you're seeing on your PowerPoint, there is a way to bring it up here. Normally, if you're doing this in class or in the computer lab in the library, it should be there. But if you're on your own personal computer or your home computer, it may not show up. So if it is not showing up, you're just going to click on a random empty space. I'm just going to choose this space over here. I'm going to right click on it and I'm going to do customize the ribbon. And so I'll get this little pop up, and what I'm looking for is record, which is right here. It is appearing on mine, which is why the check mark is there. But if it is not appearing on yours, you will see the check mark not there. So you'll just go ahead and hit the check, hit OK, and it should appear up here. So that's what we're going to click. This is one of the places we're going to be operating out of today. We're going to start with a simple version of this. So what I'm going to do is on this toolbar, I'm going to hit audio. It's going to give me a little pop-up. I'm going to say slide one. And I'm going to go ahead and start recording. So I'm going to jump into this with my recording. Hi, my name is Trisha. Welcome to PowerPoint VoiceOver Tool, a quick how-to with Trisha. And so I finished, and what you'll see is a little kind of speaker button showed up in the middle of my page. I can drag this around, move it where I think it works nicely. I can make it bigger, I can make it smaller, whatever works for me. But what you'll see is once I click on it, or even if I just hover over it, I will have that kind of play bar. So I'm going to click on it so it stays there, and I'm going to hit play. Hi, my name is Trisha. Welcome to PowerPoint VoiceOver Tool, a quick how-to with Trisha. And boom, you now have a VoiceOver audio recording. So then if I want to do the same thing for page two, I would go through the same process. I click audio, maybe name this slide two. I would hit the record button. I would do what I need to do here. And I would go ahead and get the same little speaker icon, and I'm good to go. So you would just do that for every single slide. It is a quick, easy approach to the process. It does mean that you are recording on each individual slide, but it gets the job done. I'm going to go ahead and delete this because we're going to do version two now. So back up on the record toolbar, you will see this one that says from beginning, and it has a little presentation or slideshow, and it has a record button. So that's what we're going to click next. And it's going to give me a new window, which I'm going to bring over here so you can see. And this is where I'm going to do all of my recording. So one thing that you'll notice, and I'm going to minimize this really quick, is normally PowerPoint will have this notes section open where you can type up your notes. If it is not there, you'll see this notes line or option here at the bottom. So let's say it's hidden. If you just hit that, it'll appear. I strongly advise and recommend that you go ahead and type your script out in that notes section. So this is what I want to say on slide one. I've typed it in there. This is what I want to say for slide two. I have typed it in here. It's also good when you're doing the voiceover audio recordings with the PowerPoint because it's almost like a caption. So there's accessibility that it also takes into account. So if maybe somebody is maybe a little hard of hearing, or just they simply didn't understand what you said, which is feasible. It happens sometimes. This is a nice way of ensuring that they are understanding and retaining or receiving the content that you are trying to share. So again, I strongly recommend you going ahead and typing out your script in this notes section. And when you do that, though, it also benefits you while you're recording because, as you see, that script is right here on this page. So I can record from this tool and I can see my script in my notes and I can just kind of read from it. It's calling it a teleprompter, which is nice. Very fancy way of just saying your script. So at this point, I'm going to go ahead and do a sample recording. Now, the difference between this and the one we did before is this is actually going to transition into slide two automatically. So I can just record my entire presentation straight without having to start and stop and save an audio recording for each individual slide. So that's kind of nice. It's a nice little benefit there. It also does have other tools, like I can turn my video camera on. That is not necessary for this particular assignment, but if you want to be extra or you're feeling your look that day and you feel like turning the camera on, by all means, go for it. But it does have that. It also has these annotation options down here. So as you're presenting, if you want to do like a nice little laser pointer to highlight a certain section, you can do that. You can also use your pen tool. So maybe I really want people to know that this is for PowerPoint. It's very important. I can also erase that because I don't really need that. And then I can highlight too. So I have a highlighter tool that I can use. And I'm going to erase that also. So you do have that option there as well. So with that said, I'm just going to go ahead and start recording. So we're going to go recorder mode really quick in a second. You'll notice my little red recording button is not showing. It's because I already did a recording, so it's kind of confusing it. So I'm just going to click on this button next to it and do retake video on all slides. And now it's going to give me a nice countdown. And I can begin. Hi, my name is Trisha. Welcome to PowerPoint VoiceOver Tool, a quick how-to with Trisha. As you see here, this page is just an example page. It has a lovely timeline with comments for each of the listed years. Great fun! Okay, so I went ahead and I recorded, as you just heard. One thing that I think I did, I was incorrect in saying before, is I said it automatically transitions to the next slide. It does not automatically. You transition to the next slide. It's just so it doesn't cut you off. So I get to decide, okay, now I'm going to move on to slide two and do that recording. So I just came down to this section and I hit the advance to the next slide and I moved on. If I had more slides than two, I would then continue to do that each time. The one thing I will advise is after you finish your script for one slide, go ahead and take a pause. And before you start speaking for the next slide, take another pause. I say this because sometimes you can end up clipping yourself off. So I could be this if I'm rushing through it too quickly. So let's say I finish with this one and then I click on two and I start in really quick again. I could end up cutting off the beginning of slide two. So I'm going to want to give myself that little leeway with the pauses at the end of reading a slide and at the beginning of the next slide. So just something to keep in mind. And what you'll notice, so we're back on the original presentation, and what you'll notice is the little speaker bar showed up again. Remember, I deleted the other one, so this is new. And it's also on page two. It automatically populated here in the bottom corner. It's there, and it's ready to listen to. So I've done my recordings. Now I just need to clean it up. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the little icon and you'll see audio format and playback at the top showed up. So if I'm off of that, I'm not going to see it. But the moment I click on the little icon, there they are. We're going to click on playback. This is where we're going to have access to trim the audio. So you'll see that option located here at the top. It's going to give me this lovely new pop-up, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to hit play and I can begin. Hi. So I'm kind of seeing my marker. This is why I'm listening to it. So around this really loud part, because apparently I was very energetic when I said hi, that's where I want it to kind of start. I am going to give myself a little lead-in, though, like a little pause before I officially say hi, hopefully cutting off any previous talking I was doing, just because there's sometimes, again, going with that clipping thing, sometimes when the presentation is being done with the audio, it may clip the beginning if you don't have that space. So let's try to move this. We're just going to drag that little first tab thing here closer to where I get a little louder. Let's see. Hi, my name is... I'm going to see if I can get away with opening it up a little bit more. Hi. And a little bit more. So this is going to be fun. You're going to have lots of fun hearing your own voice. Hi, my name... I'm just going to do one more scooch and we'll see. Hi. Okay. I think that's good. And we'll double check it in a moment here. So there, the beginning is good to go. I'm set. I had a lot of dead air here at the end, which was intentional. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull that in. So I'm kind of looking at the audio frequency. So I'm seeing that towards the end, it's kind of a straight line. So I'm going to bring that in closer to where I was obviously still talking, giving myself again just a little bit of room. So we'll see. With Trisha. Okay. I can give myself just a little bit more room, but that should be good. So there we go. I've clipped the beginning where I liked it, and I've clipped the end where I liked it. I'm just going to hit OK now. And we'll hit play. Hi, my name is Trisha. Welcome to PowerPoint VoiceOver Tool, a quick how-to with Trisha. And boom, it's exactly how I wanted. So I would go ahead and I do the same thing with the second one. So I'm going to click on it. I will see playback up here. We're already there. I'm going to click on trim audio. Okay, that works for me. So I'm going to hit OK. As you see here, this page, and there we go. Once it comes to saving, again, this is going to be probably the easiest part of the whole process. You can just save this like you normally would. So you could just come right up to that little floppy disk image at the top and hit save, save as, name it however you need to name it, and send this as what you can submit to your professor. With that said, there you have it. You have now learned how to record an audio voiceover for PowerPoint. There are lots of different ways that you can play around with this. Feel free to explore, even if it's not something that you want to just learn directly from me for this particular assignment. But it's fun to kind of explore and see what options are there within PowerPoint, because there are so many more than what I just shared with you today. But with that said, if you have any questions or you want to chat with me, I am still here in class, or there, I guess you can say. So feel free to raise your hand and ask questions. Hopefully we have some time for you to kind of play around a little bit with it, at least knowing and identifying where things are. If you'd like to ask questions after this, though, you can always get in contact with me. I will probably cover this some more in class, but for the sake of this video, you could reach out to me through email at patricia.hernandez@tamucc.edu. And we can either chat through email or we can set up a Zoom or in-person consultation. And I'm happy to sit down with you and chat. That is the end of this little tutorial piece of this session. Hopefully it was easy and it's something that you can refer back to if needed. Again, I will be posting this to YouTube for the library's YouTube channel, and I will make sure that your professor has the link so that they can share it with you as well. Thank you all, and have a good one. Take care.